as you know, in modern technology, especially just now with the whispering unit, you lost your way also. So the modern whispering unit is good, but remember, in the old town, one turn only, you're going to lose your way. Okay, to the left side, you can see the old town again. It's a beautiful Toledo. Okay, the St. Martin Bridge. So just imagine the Muslims, the Arab, when they are here for almost 800 years, everybody is living peacefully together.
Same way of the scenic road.
And this is a favorite place for people to come for a day tour for Madrid also. Because it's about an hour drive from Madrid.
So,
哇，它的屋顶很美。
And finally, we have a triangle, the lower part of the emblem with the fruit. This is a pomegranate that represents Granada.
Climate change.
Yes. Because we're holding this in Madrid. It was supposed to be done in Chile, but because of the situation.
Princess. Thank you.
that is our local parliament. Yes. A ver si se puede ver. Okay, see here on the right is where you have this zero point max on the floor. You see these people here on the right taking pictures of it. Down there on the right on the sidewalk. And there to the left you have people everywhere. You know, this is the Christmas period, is where everybody goes up shopping, and well, I always said this is like a shopping fever until the second week of January. And here you have all the shops, a few pedestrian streets, and at the end of the street is a Gran Via. Gran Via is the main street. We cannot drive through in Christmas because it's cut to the too heavy, you know, buses like ours or tracks. And well, by doing this, they try to help the flow of traffic, but it's not easy because, you know, traffic is one of our main problems here. Then everybody comes. Madroño tree. Madroño is a quite common tree in this part of the country, in this central part of Spain. It's not a big tree, but it has some fruits that look like, it's like it kept some of the names of some of the gates of that wall. And in this place where we are now was one of the gates of the city wall, Sun Gate. So we don't have the gate, but we have the name. So this is, that's why we call it, the people used to call it the bank area. And see what we have in front of us? Chamber is the Senate with 80 senators and dedicated to the god of the sea in the Roman mythology. And that's the Prado on the right. There you have one of the entrances to the museum where we have this great collection of paintings. There are about 10,000 paintings in its permanent collection. So it's nowadays one of the most important painting galleries all over the world, the Prado Museum. There to the left is another fountain, this one dedicated to the god Apollo, the god of love. But here we have three fountains from the same period, dedicated to three goddesses and gods. Neptune, Apollo, and the next one is Cibeles. Cibeles was the goddess of fertility and nature from the Greek mythology. It's a very old goddess, Mother Earth as well. It's always represented on a carriage with the two lions. Cibeles, 18th century. Today, the city hall head office, although for many years it's been the post office. And then we have the Cibeles fountain on the left. And also beyond the trees on the left, behind the gardens, we have the army headquarters, left hand side. And here on the left also, in this avenue, we have only temporary kind of antiques fair and also handicrafts. Something they put every Christmas. They sell all kind of handicraft and jewels and things. And now we are about to arrive in Colombo Square. And Colombo Square is a new square compared to others. Square dedicated to this famous Italian navigator called Christopher Columbus. Italian, as I was telling you. I always insist because, you know, a lot of people think that he was Spanish. Taken to other cities all over the world, so will be exhibited in many other places for, I don't know for how long, but for a long time. In Madrid, only 1 year. that it was done by a Spanish artist, Jaume Plensa. The name he gave to this big face is Julia. This is the National Library on the right hand side. Vamos a poner aquí unos minutitos. See, this is Julia on the right hand side with the closed eyes, meaning, you know, representing like somebody looking inside. And also to the right, you have the entrance to a cultural center that is below the square, where we have some theaters, exhibition rooms, etc. And also in the center of the square, you have a big Spanish national flag. This is the biggest one in the world, 290 square meters. The biggest Spanish flag in the world. See, here you have also on the right, you have three big monoliths and three big sculptures that represent the three ships, the three caravels that Columbus brought to America. Pinta, Niña, and Santa Maria, right? And this building on the right is well, here we have the National Library that you have seen on the other side, and in this side we have in the same building. The building is from the 19th century. It's been restored recently, that's why it looks so new, but it's not new. They have been cleaning the main facade, repairing this, so it looks new, but it's from the 19th century. So there you can read Biblioteca, which means library, and now his father, Philip V, called him to come to Spain to occupy the throne. So he took with him a lot of Italian architects and sculptures, and they all work in Spain for him. For example, Sabatini. Sabatini was an Italian architect. In Madrid we have four gates. This is one of them. It's the nicest one, the oldest. Look at the traffic, how is it changing a little bit. That's always one of our problems. Let's see if we can, if we have the opportunity of seeing the Christmas lights. Yeah, I don't know. Let's see. And Alcalá Gate, Puerta de Alcalá on the left-hand side. And also on the left-hand side, we have the Retiro Park. In Madrid, there are many parks, about 40 public parks and gardens, but that park on the left is the most popular one in town, and also the oldest one. It's a park from the 17th century that for many years was a private property, see? A park used only by the kings. And at the time of Queen Isabel II, the opening to the public, which was the end of the 19th century. See, now to go to the restaurant, We have to turn left, so we'll pass again by the fountain that you have seen before, but now it's getting green color. And also the National Bank is there in the corner on the left. And now we're going back to Colombo Square. Well, I suppose, I don't know if you have noticed that here and there, everywhere in the city, we have some, yeah, these figures, these are little sculptures. They look like big dolls. And we call them meninas. Menina is a character represented by a very famous painter called Velázquez, his most famous painting, the family of King Philip IV. So to these days we have just temporary this exhibition of different meninas. There are around 50 meninas spread all over the city, these big dolls, done by different artists. Well, not only artists, but also soccer players or tennis players or, you know, actors, actresses, you know, all kind of people. So they are all different. It's the same silhouette, but different painting, different everything. Only the figure is the same. It's the same spread in the city. We have like four, one of them at the airport, and the other one here. That Botero used to always represent. So people said Botero always paints and works with the fat figures. But he said, my figures are not fat, they are only volumetric. So this is, you will see one of them, which means Julia on the right. And now we'll see the lady with the mirror by the Christmas tree on the left on the sidewalk. It's not easy to see it, especially when it gets dark, because it's a figure made of black bronze. So it's not easy to see at night time. So you know, the reason you have all this by the police car is where the lady with the mirror is, see? On the left, on the sidewalk. So I was telling you that our public transport is very the way we have this. So because of the proximity of this university, we have a lot of shops and restaurants for young people, also a lot of apartments, to rent, residence for students. Per year, which is almost, it's not a big money. I think that our medium salary is